recording artist in the world next to Ricky Martin.
Like that, and I lived in the Bronx, so that it was really big there.
It was the number 6 train that a young Lopez took from the Bronx to Manhattan for singing and dancing classes. And her driving ambition would surely pay off. After busting onto the scene as a fly girl and taking on roles in various TV series, Lopez's career took off by appearing in such films as Anaconda and Out of Sight. But it was her role in Selena which made the actress remember her true passion, singing. 'Cause I'm dreaming. She pursued that dream and eventually landed a recording contract with Sony Records. Lopez would soon hook up with Grammy Award-winning producer Rodney Jerkins.
Met Rodney that day, Rodney Jerkins, and he came in and he was like, yeah, I want to do some stuff for you and this and that. And I'm like, okay. And he sits down with me at the board and I'm like, play him this, this and this. And we sit there and he's listening. He's like, all right. The next day he comes back with like 9 different ideas of songs, and he's like, pick whichever one do you want, and I picked 2. I was like, this one and this one, and we did.
When I first did the track, I knew it was a hit.
If You Had My Love rose to number 1 on Billboard's Top 10 after just 5 weeks on the charts, knocking off another Latino lighting up the music scene. Ricky, Enrique, Luis, who would be her choice for a duet on her debut album?
Mark was my first choice. When they were like, do you want to do a duet? Have you thought about it? How about so-and-so? How about so-and-so? And I was like, Mark Anthony, please. But no, I'm like his biggest fan. He calls when he's like in the car and he's like, I have the song. I'm like, you have the song? He's like, yeah, it's this old Italian song that I've always loved and I want to do it with you. It's a beautiful ballad. It's like a conversation between 2 people. It's a really beautiful song. I'm really proud of it. It was funny, Mark Anthony said something to me when we were in the studio. He was like, I know you believe it. Now when I hear it, make me believe it. And to me, that was really something that it like clicked things over for me. You know, I was like, yeah, I can believe it. I can be singing it. But somebody else has got to hear it. That's why people ask me, you know, you're an actress, or you're a singer, or are you this, and I just go, I'm a performer. You know, that's what I do. I'm an entertainer.
But don't count on this Latin beauty to put a halt on her movie career. She'll be seen next year in the films The Wedding Planner and Pluto Nash. Up next on Viva, the amazing jazz flutist Nestor Torres tells of his near-death experience.